All right, how about this? I've put all my three fucking favourites together to hit a man. I've thrown Tadakatsu Honda in there, just because we've not seen him yet. And it sort of... I don't know if you technically unlock him in this story. Because, like, him and Lu Bu, I think, are two, well, like, they're the two sort of... recognized as being the two strongest warriors of their respective eras, so you sort, like, the unlock conditions for them are a bit more unusual. But, like, we had a bonding experience with the guy in this story, at least, so it's sort of, like, if he's going to show up anywhere, here makes sense. And the fight is non-canon anyway. We're going to Chibi, or Chirbi. This is another one where the pronunciation changed over time in the games. And I don't recall... I think it's Chirbi. Perhaps. But we're gonna go there, and we're gonna burn all their ships, because that's what you do. Like, that's how they won the fight, and I'm gonna go back on hard. Like, I'll figure out what I want to do. The time was at right. Some point, the final showdown with the Orochi army. An alternate version of history where we fought this, you on a boat. Orochi had gathered every soldier at his disposal to the cliffs of Chibi. If this you're saying Chi, could be broken, but we don't know that. Would have been laid for the decisive battle to come.
Ieyasu and Sakon advanced their army into Chibi in an attempt to wipe out the masses of the Orochi army.
Good stuff. So this one does occur before the... I don't know. The chronology of all of this is baffling to me. Let's just have a fight. Let's just have a fight and see who thinks it's good that we're having a fight. God's sake. Who even cares? Who even cares? Look at all these boats. We're going to set fire to them because that's, you know... There is no greater crime. We are here. In Chir/Chibi. You have to set fire to the boats at least once. We will be relying on your
strategical acumen. Right.
Strategical.
We might start things off.
Strategical boop. Stridly biddly whoop. Don't forget to have someone in the enemy ranks planted there to make sure all of the boats are chained together so they can't readily separate. All to be careful.
There was,
There was a movie that I know exists that sort of follows, Pang Tong. Who was the guy sort of responsible for that aspect of the plan at Chibi. Chaining all the boats together, making sure it's correct. Sort of a movie about that followed him doing that, and I never saw it. I just know that it exists. It was like one of a couple. I don't even remember the context fully of where I saw. I think I was like on holiday in Wales, and I was like, right, we've picked a place where there's nothing fucking here. I want to watch a movie, please, and it was sort of in and among the ones that were available. I never ended up seeing it. And I've always kind of wanted to, despite not remembering the name, and not really having- Oh God, the abyss! just delete the boat. Delete the goddamn boat. Please don't hit me in the sky. We're stopping that bridge, are we? I thought we'd already stopped the bridge. I am a man of fearless might. You need to figure out which bridge you're on. I am most fortunate to have such a worthy retainer. For God's sake. Bring it on. Stop being here. Stop being here at once. I won't lose Are you sufficiently harmed? I'm glad. Who's these bonus lads downstairs? Who's here as a third army? Not technically part of ours, but still affiliated. I should probably help you out. Did I blow up the bridge correctly? Oh, there's an offence captain. There's an offence captain. I thought it was the officer's responsibility. Let me go. Come on. Yeah, now we're cooking with fast. Now we're going a ways away. Craftily picked up my own fingers. Yeah. Blow it up.
Reinforcements now.
No, reinforcements later. Firewood now. Get me some timber, won't you? Pick it up from the timber store. Pick it up from Timberland. What's that fucking? What's his clothing brand? You can use that for kindling. I think most of that's made of wood. There's got to be some reason it's called that. We don't know. Oh, hello. You're here. It's you. Hi. You're one of our... We can get the... Have a friend multiply. You're quite right. All the points bonuses practically write themselves. I can sit on my chair. Ha! It's the last thing he ever heard.
That's the way to do it.
Right, let's hurt everybody on land. Who's the shrine? Do you want me to do a little prayer to make it look like I'm affecting the winds? Do you want me to do my little pray?
Engineers, move out.
Do you want me to play pray? The original or the that did get remade, right?
Fire traps were so obvious, it sickens me.
I think was Prey 2 the one where like there was this really cool looking trailer for it, and then it never ended up amounting to anything. And then another Prey game got made that ended up not being that. And it was like fairly good from what I heard. Am I remembering the legacy of Prey correctly? Am I remembering those fingers? Oh, please! Go on, turn round! God, that just made me remember the fucking... The legacy of Kane people put out a survey for what people would want to see from a new game. I'd forgotten about that and I'm excited again now. I hope that comes to something. I really do. That series has had such bad luck with like its intentions versus its ability to execute. But if a new fucking one of them comes out, I'm so torn between like just having a minute to if one did come out, would I want to just play it myself? And like sort of have that experience without needing to worry about presenting a thing? Or would I want to like have my live reactions to everything recorded? I don't know. I don't typically do them live. I don't typically record series for getting live reactions. Usually if I'm like, if it seems like I'm reacting for the first time, it's because I've forgotten what was in the game. Like I'm doing initial reactions for Resi 4 remake right now. But to be honest, like I sort of knew already, having played the original Resi 4, I knew to a certain extent what to expect. And B, I sort of didn't care all that much. I don't... Like, the game's fine. There's some shitty stuff happening around it on sort of the business side of things that I don't appreciate. But it's not... That's not a problem with the game itself yet. Like, as you know, these things, stuff that gets introduced on the monetization side can end up having stuff in the main game sort of rebalanced around it, thereby poisoning everything else. You can feel the poisonous influence deep within the mine, can't you? All this iron is getting horribly sick. But, what was I saying up until that point? I think the thing about, a new Legacy of Kain game is that I would be sort of genuine. Oh, we've had engineers out this whole time! Fuck me.
That puts the dampener on my fire attack.
I was busy running my mouth the whole time. I didn't even know that there was a fucking plan in place.
Nobody knows of the trouble I've seen.
That is, like, that's the thing I said was, I was worried was going to happen, is I was concentrating on everything, like, my full focus is not on what's going on. And so I didn't notice that plans were in place. I've said it had happened, and now it has, so you'd know that I wasn't just making it up. Okay, I'm paying more attention to what the plan is now. So hurting everyone over here is part of it. My big move hurt you all today at once. Be in pain. In an interesting way, it sort of mirrors my experience with the difficulty settings. In as much as, like, it's all either too much or too little. Like, it's... Oh, please! It exists in this weird space. Where, like, I'm either paying too much attention to what's going on, and so... Like, I end up going quiet and not doing my job as a fucking commentator, or I'm in too much of a flow with talking about everything and I don't notice that the fucking fire attack unit's in jeopardy. I am unable to find that middle ground where everything's exactly where you would want it to be. And that's a... Like, I've sort of put off covering these games for that reason. It never quite felt like I was ready, and now I'm left with basically only these... I've pretty much only got the Warriors games left to cover at this stage. Out of the ones that I've sort of played a whole bunch. There's PS2 stuff I can still get into if I want to get into it. I know, we love blowing things up. Accidentally narrowed my field of view. What? Fuck, thank you. Thank you for finally being in front of my eyes. Stop hitting other people off horses, that's my job. I'm the man who hits you off the horse. I am the man who hits you with an appropriate amount of force. Ho 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 ho. Right, now to oot the other bridge. Okay, that's where the engineers have started off. I'm glad. I will keep... Oh, and then you notice it, and you're going away somewhere. Why? You're, like, really far away. I would have, like, sent a message to someone closer to, like, go and deal with it. I guess you don't trust them to do that. You don't trust anybody in the area to handle your big, mighty fucking finale. Hurt the bridge! Right, the bridge has been hurt. Where's the... Now I need to find the engineers. Engineers, assemble all of your funny little ideas at once. I know, we all eat a bridge at once. Once or twice. There you are. Right, I'm gonna stick by you. And everyone else can go fuck themselves. You can assume you're going to end up over here ultimately. Because there's no real other way off the boat at this point. You may struggle, but what do you want me to do about it? I'm helping a small man cross the street. I'm sort of wondering, it's kind of a shame that Dynasty Warriors 9 was, like, I think actually the most recent Samurai Warriors game as well, sort of, didn't that go in a weird direction that was sort of, like, was that one, like, critically not very well received as well? I feel like I'm remembering. Although, I think, to be honest, I've only really heard the opinions of one James Stephanie Sterling. Who, to be honest, if I'm going to listen to anyone on the subject, like, they were one of the few who'd go to bat for the series. I can only imagine. That's the way of the Raisins, isn't it? The Raisins will stand by you. But if even the Raisins flee, then what you got left? You can't even keep the Raisins on board. Someone's on the other end of the plane throwing them all away. Throwing all the Raisins off the plane. Why have you got the doors open? Isn't that going to depressurize? I'm so sorry, I've dropped a big tower on your head. But the reason I was talking about it is because I was thinking, I'm going to have to go on one more tangent in order to set up the context for this, but essentially I'm wondering what, like, if instead of just focusing on, like, graphical fidelity and all that, sort of like the technical, oh, we're ray tracing all of your bloody eyes. Now you can see yourself in my eyes, Christopher Lee, so you know that I'm not a unicorn for real this time. Right, instead of all of this fucking elaborate ray tracing technology to trick Christopher Lee into thinking we're not the last unicorn, they had focused instead on expanding the actual scope of the games. Because, like, Sonic Frontiers...
Do you think you can stop me?
Hear me out. I don't actually think... Like, the technology... Like, I'm sure it's technically impressive. Like, for what that team is used to putting out. Like, they've not really done an open world thing. Like, I'm not trying to downplay the effort involved in achieving something like that. To be honest, I would genuinely consider the original Sonic Adventure to be a more ambitious thing in terms of, like, the scope of what it was doing. Like, it just sort of feels like, you know, I can't speak to anything on the technical side of things. I just kind of feel as though there was more going on under the hood of the original Sonic Adventure. Because, like, ultimately, when you break it down, the big innovation of Sonic Frontiers is he's doing it in a large field. A large, unstylized field populated with, like, visually dissonant Sonic game assets. And I don't know... Like, if for someone who knows, like, the numbers... side of it, and, you know, what goes into the actual construction, I'm sure it seems a lot more impressive from that regard, but in terms of what was actually made, like, we've kind of seen this. Like, it's the concept of it is not really mind-blowing unless you know the technical side of how it all needs to be done. Like, If that makes sense. I'm sort of having to talk through all of this as a complete layman, so I don't know if this is strictly... It's like, where I'm at is sort of like, all that effort and, like, what was it ultimately for? because I don't think the impressiveness of the end result was ever ultimately going to match like the level of scrunch you needed to put, like the thing they've expanded, the thing they've put all that energy into didn't feel like it was the thing that was. To me, anyway, I mean, like, having him run around, having him have a big expanse of place to run around in at that speed is probably. I just don't. Like, it's just a field. you know? It feels like you've given him a big field to run around in, but it feels like you've lost the world.
This isn't looking so good.
Like, it really does feel like he's just in a field. It doesn't help that it's like the ruins of a civilization that's like dead before he even gets there, so there is no, you know, there is very much no sense of life in this place. But like, if it's not Station Square, if it's not like the Green Hill Zone style place of that size, it's sort of like, what's the point? You know, everyone's got a game where they run around in a big, sort of generic-looking field at this point. I think it is the fact that the location itself doesn't feel stylized to match with the sort of Sonic the Hedgehog aesthetic. So, like, honestly, I wouldn't have minded if it was another, like, technically open world, but there's like still loading zones between all of the areas sort of deal, like it was in Sonic Adventure, because like that way the individual smaller locations, the energy could have been put into making them like a thing that didn't just feel like a random patch of grass where you'd put a bunch of weird little fucking jumping puzzles that are unconnected to anything else. Like, it doesn't feel like a world, it feels like a contrivance. This conversation was supposed to be about the Dynasty Warriors series. I got so fucking into, like, trying to explain my opinions vis-a-vis how I felt about that game that I completely lost sight of why it was relevant. Which feels sort of ironic, or at least thematic, in a strange way, given the nature of the conversation. But, like, on a matter of expanding scope, I do kind of wonder what a game like this, where you're supposed to be fighting a whole-ass war, would look like if, like, and, like, the tragic thing is, like, my understanding is Dynasty Warriors 9 all, like, in a sense was that. Like, the maps were bigger, but it was like they were also less dense. It felt like there was less going on. I don't fully remember. I know the big thing is like they gave everybody like a series of generic move sets. Like they really fucking. Oh yeah, like they removed a bunch of the more interesting weapons, and like everybody had like shared movesets they could do with a handful of more generic weapons, and then they sold the more interesting weapons back to you as DLC. I fucking wrote, like, they put the weapons back in, but you had to pay extra for them. That was fucking, that, man, fuck that game. Now that I've remembered, fuck that game entirely. So many raisins. Oh, no, don't struggle over there, please. You're probably a commander, I would imagine. Well, you're not quite the commander, but you're like a big person in charge of the fire. a big person in charge of the fire, which is a sort of a position left over from caveman times. We've not abolished the position yet. We've not quite moved away from our fire-based finger economy. I've completely forgotten any kind of point that I was making now. It's all gotten off track because of Sonic the Hedgehog and me suddenly remembering DLC that was done. But, like, I don't know. Like, if we didn't... I graphically don't think we needed to evolve that far beyond what the PS2 was doing. To be like, I think PS2 games still look very nice. And if we had instead put that energy into, like, expanding the conceptual scope, I'm curious to see what that would have yielded. I guess. I want, because, to be honest, a lot of the more recent Warriors-style games, and I don't know if it's just because I became more cognizant of the fact that there is very much a plan in place and an order in which you're supposed to do things, but the games started feeling smaller to me as time went on. Like, I think, to be honest, even, like, in terms of the size of the stages, I don't know. Like, it's one of the reasons I kind of want to do Dynasty Warriors 4 on the channel, is because it'll give me an opportunity to, like, remember if that's actually true. Sort of, like, renew my point of comparison for thinking that. Or, I might stand before you. Right, this is how, have I not? I'd like to do that. I'm gonna go hurt the guy. Like, this is how you unlock Lubu as a playable character, is like in every one of these extra stages. Well, the door's locked. I'm not running around all of these boats just to get to you to prove a point, but like if you do get to him and prove a point in each of the extra stages in the game, that's how you unlock him. That's how you unlock him, so that's great. I'm now going to hurt a snake until he either goes home or dies. Depending on whether this is like a thing that canonically happened or an alternate ending to the story. One of those two things is going to really be here today. One of these two things is going to make this snake go away. One of it's really, really going to stamp. You're not like... You're still not... You keep just doing one little attack. All he knows is how to step forward and slash his side once, and he does nothing else, no matter the difficulty. Oh, no, he's did it! He did something! He fell from the sky! Most of it happened off-screen. Most of the force of that took place off-screen. He finally beat the allegations and the cameras weren't rolling. You gotta feel for the guy. You've got to feel the lump on his neck. Let's make sure that's nothing serious, eh? Let's make sure nothing damning's going on in your throat. Ho ho! The end has not even really happened. Nobody has anything to say after that. A snake just dies on a boat and then the world carries on. Well, this has been an interesting experience. I got very into talking about something I completely fucking lost track of. And, we only need range. And what was I saying? Fuck me. Right, I clearly need to take a moment to just go and reset my brain. So I will do that. So how about you all get out of my way and fucking let me, eh? I'll see you again at some point for the start of someone else's story in this game. Goodbye. My God.